I start with boxes of bagged clay that come to me, and it's just a big lump of wet, sticky stuff. And I can make that into whatever I want to, that when I walk out in the studio, if my heart's desire is to make a bunch of mugs for the day, or if I want to make a bunch of tiles or bowls or, you know, whatever it is, I can just sort of set my mind to it, take that lump of clay, and it can become really anything.
Potter Jenny Brandt loves to live by her artistic impulses of the moment. She's been working with ceramics for about 12 years now, and she likes nothing more than to be up to her elbows in clay.
And I just sit down at the wheel, if that's where the piece needs to start, and I just start really playing. I think that's one of the things I love about clay too, is that it's total play.
Brandt works out of a studio in her home in Nebraska City. She finds inspiration in the quiet pace of this historic tree-shaded community of more than 7,000 people.
At the basis of it, it's just about taking in my everyday environment and taking time to notice the things that I find kind of spectacular or exceptionally beautiful, and taking a moment to take those in and bring maybe some elements from those things into my work. It might be that I just found some new textile pattern that I really want to try putting on the work, so I'll implement that. And it just seems they're happy little pots that way.
Brandt makes functional pottery that can be displayed, but is meant to be used.
I didn't want to be making the work that just hung on the gallery walls that you could only touch with your eyes. I wanted you to be able to touch with your hands, because for me, that's what drew me to clay, was the touch of it, the feel of it, the working of it. And so you just automatically go to making functional ceramics because people are going to use that in their everyday lives.
Brandt describes her own work as feminine, curvy, delicate yet practical. She wants her pieces to make even the most ordinary foods a celebration.
There's a piece that I sort of feel is one of my signature pieces. I make an egg server, basically a deviled egg tray that's up on a pedestal, and it's in my style of work, and it's highly decorated and very delicate. But deviled eggs aren't really that fancy of a thing, so I just started working on making a piece that would be a fancier serving piece to kind of elevate the status of those deviled eggs.
Even butter is celebrated when housed in the aptly named Butter Shrine. But working with clay is only one part of her artistic life. By day, she is the executive director of the Kimmel Harding Nelson Center for the Arts in Nebraska City. The KHN, as it is also known, has an artist-in-residency program that draws artists from all over the world.
We can have up to 5 artists at a time. This last round we had applications from Switzerland, Ghana, London, but primarily from the United States we get our applications, and they're from anywhere across the country. We get a lot of artists from New York, a lot from California, but we also have a special mission to support artists in Nebraska.
The idea is to support emerging and established visual artists, writers, or even composers by providing living and working space in which they can reflect and create. Artists can apply for residencies that last anywhere from 2 to 8 weeks, and there are no requirements to finish a work while at the center.
Yeah, it's working for me really well to go from the groups to sort of like the intimate portraits.
Mm-hmm.
And then
I like the tent portraits.
You do?
I do. There's something.
Omaha painter Tana Quincy is just into her 3rd week of her residency, and she's already seeing an impact on her creative process.
I'm kind of starting to experiment again. I think when I was in such a structured environment of being like, okay, pay the bills, take care of loans, take care of teaching my classes, I just would go into my studio and just kind of feel like I had to produce something. But here, it's more like just the real feeling of making art again.
Yeah, he'll probably go like that, you know, shrink it down. But these patterns, I think I told you, are from those Victorian Valentines. Yeah.
Printmaker Catherine Sheehan is making prints of endangered animals from Nebraska. She's from the Bay Area of California, but enjoys the slower pace of a small town.
You know, I'm just kind of hitting my flow, and I'm feeling like I don't want to go home. you kind of hit a different kind of rhythm where you get up, you know, maybe you have your coffee, and then you come and you work in your studio. And it's amazing. It's such a treat because it's not how I normally get to do my practice.
It's the most endangered mammal in North America.
Really?
Yeah, it's actually.
Since the program began a decade ago, nearly 400 artists have come through the center.
There's a sump pump thing on the one in Studio 2. See, this is my glamorous job.
She's part administrator, part hotel manager for artists, coordinating supplies and maintenance.
You could honestly get there at 7:10.
She's also an ambassador of Nebraska City to these temporary residents. And sometimes, she's just a studio potter, getting together with friends, serving ordinary food in extraordinary vessels.